Sneaky chance. Needs to sit a bit closer. Missed the start slightly. That was Johnny Angel, in fact. Sneaky chance began okay. Warm and Fuzzy flew out. Goes through now, takes a lead from Captain Kink. Don't Fuss. And then came. Going through on the inside now is Sneaky Chance with a nice move up on the inside. Vane Tempest is out wider. Ghost Who Walks is back in the centre. And then came Ruka, who's three deep with Cuther, running about eight, followed by Dark Mish in the middle. Johnny Angel, the inside. Sunny Silk, Pink Carrots is last. Warm and Fuzzy's got the lead. Can't get away from them. Captain Kink, the outside. Don't Fuss doing it tough. Vane Tempest with a nice trail. Ghost Who Walks the centre. Sneaky Chances right there for O'Donnell on the inside. Tracks up behind Warm and Fuzzy. Johnny Angel is tracking Sneaky Chance. Back behind them is Ruka. And further back is Dark Mission. Inside the 250. Hasn't moved on Sneaky Chance. Sneaky Chance barnstorming through on the inside. Hit the front from Warm and Fuzzy. Vane Tempest. And then Ghost Who Walks. But it's Sneaky Chance in front. Sneaky Chance holding Vane Tempest. And Ghost Who Walks. And Sneaky Chance has done it. Sneaky Chance, a beautiful ride. And beat Vane Tempest, Ghost Who Walks, and Warm and Fuzzy. And then Ruka, not a bad effort, followed by just behind them was Don't Fuss, who toughed it out well after racing very wide. And then Sunny Silk, who was out wider. Dark Mission might have been a bit closer up there. And further back in the field was Johnny Angel, Captain Kink, and tailing off Pink Carrots. Sneaky Chance. Wow, that was a win. Number 10 is the winner, Sneaky Chance. Gee, O'Donnell looked good on that. He was just absolutely sitting against it. It sat closer. It was Johnny Angel who missed the start in the blue colours, and Sneaky Chance actually began well and shot right up behind Warm and Fuzzy. And from that spot, knowing the turn of foot he's got, to sit that close and be travelling that comfortably, it was basically, if you're in the run, you're thinking, it's the only horse really that you wanted to be on, because it's got a turn of foot, it was close to the speed. And one of its dangers had drifted right out the gate and was last Pink Carrot, so it was out of it. Ghost Who Walks was a fair way back. And the other one, Warm and Fuzzy, was only just in front at the front of the field. So it didn't leave much for Sneaky Chance to overcome. A long head by one, 10, 3, 7 and 2. Nice run by Vane Tempest. Three deep with cover, ran home well. Ghost Who Walks sliced his way through, as he usually does, into a placing. And Warm and Fuzzy toughed it out. Just put in a missed stride there, I thought, maybe at the 100-metre mark, just watching it live. And just faded back to fourth. Don't Fuss. Was a good effort fifth. It was three wide, no cover. It's getting closer. And then we had Sunny Silk behind them with Dark Mission. So the winner, Sneaky Chance, is just in incredible form. Always shown a lot of promise from its younger days. It put in a promising couple of runs early before being turned out. Trevor Andrews done a great job with this horse. And we'll head downstairs and Brittany can tell us all about it.
Andrew's down here in the yard. Trev, we were just talking off air last time out when she ran second to No White Flag. Todd was very quick to be laughing with you, saying that she would be getting dizzy because she'd been going around and around. But the 30-day spacing, or near on, has been perfect for her today.
Yeah, exactly. Just a nice freshen up with the way the race is programmed. I don't do a lot with her. She just spends a lot of time on the treadmill and a bit of light work and all that. She hasn't left the stable. I didn't worry about putting her in the paddock. They go out there and the weather's not too pretty. So she's spoiled rotten in the stables, rugged up, kissed and cuddled every day. And she's racing super. Couldn't be happier with her. Really good ride from Sean. Pre-race, he said that he'd behind the leader's back and wait for the rails run, and got the job done well. So full credit to my wife Joanne that does all the work on her. Really happy with her. Gallop Tuesday was as good as ever. So we'll just, you know, she's had a throat up, so I'll just keep tinkering along quietly. You put these fillies in the paddock for a couple of months and then it takes you another 2 months to get them back. If you can just sort of tinker along with them, I think it's better for them. So she's enjoying her racing and may it continue.
How important is that as well, given she's had the throat up, for her confidence as well, while she's sky high with her confidence, to keep her racing?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, as soon as she puts in a bad one, I'd say stop, but she's really happy with the way she's going. She's eating well and she's as sound as a bell, so we'll just play along quietly. You know, she'll make a nice broodmare one day, but in the meantime, we'll continue to race.
As a three-year-old filly with Westby Platinum, it's pretty fruitful to be here at the races.
Yeah, how rude of me to forget about that, but that, you know, she's only got another couple of weeks till the end of this season. Whether I get another one in, I'm not sure. She's Westby... She's West Speed Platinum, so she gets half a bonus when she turns four, which is still a good incentive, but the full bonus is pretty special, I think.
course for the sprint trips, getting the 50% bonus is very, very good still as a four-year-old. Well done.
Thank you.
There is Trevor Andrews. Let's get to Sean O'Donnell, who I think surmised it perfectly pre-race and it all turned out just as he'd hoped.
Well, exactly right. Trevor was just saying, Sean, you thought that you'd be leaders back and then wait for the inside run. Where's the crystal ball?
Yeah, amazing how it can work out, and other times you just it doesn't work. Obviously, that leader, he always tends to lay out. So, you know, drew one, I just sat on his backside and just had to be mindful not to go for her too early because she's only got a short sprint and she'd done her best, and I seen that one coming late. I just had to try and hang on, and she did. Great job.
She's been up for a fair while now, too. I know it's only start number eight for her, but remember when she broke her maiden or she won a class one, it might have even been back at Ascot. So it's a fair while now.
Yeah, and hadn't she progressed well, you know, like for the owners and that West Speed, like we were just talking about, and for myself and Trevor and Joanne and everyone else, it's, yeah, she's given us a great ride. She's a pleasure to ride, and she's so honest, Scotty.
Dazzling Danes drawn barrier number one. Do you wait for the inside run as well?
I might have to, you know. Hope I can get a good run for Raquel again like that. She's a chance. I got no luck last start on her. I got dragged out of the race. So fingers crossed. And the last one, who knows?
Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you very much.
There is Sean O'Donnell. He's having a really good time in the saddle of late. Sneaky Chance defeats Vane Tempest. Goes to Walt. Splashes home to finish third. 10-3, 7-2. The numbers from race number eight. Two more to come here from Belmont. It ain't working because you're perfect. And I know that you're worth it. I can't walk away.